and women go to prison, most of the time it isn't for the rest of their lives. And returning to society when their prison sentence ends can be incredibly difficult. But there are some programs to help. Arthur Mondale is live with more on that.
Kim, did you know one of the most important factors driving the success of an ex-offender is landing a job? Now, a job means an ex-offender is three times less likely to become a re-offender, but employers have to be willing to hire. Ex-offenders, too, not only want a basic job, but competitive employment. Here are some of the triad's success stories.
Need for right now. But
ex-offenders Kamiami Sho and Sammy Johnson have a lot in common.
Habitual felon.
First degree burglary and armed robbery.
Prior felons who vow never to go back behind bars. They not only landed a job, but quickly worked their way up the employment ladder.
And it took me a year from being a cook to becoming a shift manager. Now I got a two-year goal that I want to be the manager of my own store.
We have a goal within 1 year. He will be a general manager.
Skinner speaking.
And it's that kind of equal opportunity that reentry programs like the Darryl Hunt Project are asking more area employers to make.
But they paid their debt to society. They did their time, you know. And if we're forgiving society, then we have to be able to forgive people. Not forget, but be able to forgive.
Hunt's no stranger to the debt or being shortchanged. After being wrongly convicted for a murder and having to shed a label, he made reintegrating prisoners back into society his number one priority.
If you just get out here on a whim, you're not going to make it.
But this kind of homecoming starts well before offenders actually are released. Hunt's staff meets with area prisoners at least once a week.
Job readiness, financial literacy.
Preparations that take funding. But these success stories, law-abiding citizens who are gainfully employed, are the rewards.
Somebody gave me a second chance, so why not pass it on?
My drive and my heart is in youth counseling.
If a straw's laying on the floor, don't step over it, pick it up. So just go the extra mile and success will follow you.
A very good closing statement. By the way, it's estimated that 98% of all prisoners behind bars will one day be released. So organizations like the Darryl Hunt Project will continue to need public funding to prepare these future workers. The contact info is listed on the screen.